You know that feeling when you open up Ableton, you stare at the empty screen, and you have no idea what to do? I myself been there thousands of times over the past 25 years. And now I built something that is going to solve it forever. Let's go! Okay, so what is the Magic Trance Music Maker? It's a set of tools I developed for Ableton Live in order to help you guys to make music faster, more efficient, and with ease. So let's start from the beginning. We have the kick over here, and that consists of several lines of kicks that you can use. Each kick is modifiable, so you can change how warm it is, how punchy it is, how much click there is, and how it hits. We have this kick over here. Can go really crazy, and of course you can push it to random and get your desired kick that way. Next up is the sub bass. Of course you can use your own sub bass using your favorite synthesizer, but also you can use different bass lines that I added to this project. So all you need to do is just solo one of these sub basses and just push play. So it's super easy to use and very intuitive. And of course, you can change the frequency of those bass lines so they feel a little bit more warm. We're gonna open up the session view and we're gonna start from the top. You have several bass lines that you can choose from. And now mid basses. You can just choose so many of these and you can actually change them as you go until you get the one that you really like. So let's maybe try with this one. I'm not happy. I like that one. Now, let's add the other bass line to it. Oh, I like this. So perfect, so now we have the kick, bass, and the mid basses. As you can see over here, it looks like this, but don't freak out about it. You know which of these bass lines are your favorite. You can change the color just so you know which you choose to be your best or your favorite. And you know, this way you will not lose whatever you liked the most. Next up would be the percussion. What I did, I created this thing they called a open huts maker, and this is a really cool tool because I already pre-made like about 10 different variations of the open hut, and you can just swap in between them. And it really depends which one you like the most. If you're not sure, you can actually just push the random button. And it creates the whole thing for you. This is what I like about this one. It's super cool. Next up would be the ride maker. And this is pretty much the same thing. All you need to do is just choose whatever you want or modify it to your liking or push the random button. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Maybe a little bit longer open hut. This one just consists of many closed samples. Everything is already laid down for you. All you need to do is pick the one that you like the most. I actually like this one. This would be my favorite. Next up is the clap. Now, again, this consists of many claps that you can choose from, and you can just, you know, EQ that clap, make it a little bit shorter, so you can like really play around or just, you know, pick one and go for it. Let's see which clap we like the most. Let's say I like this one. Next up is the loops. Again, this is just filled with samples of loops that are all warped, so you can play this on different BPMs. You can just choose whichever loop you like. And again, you have the second one in case you want to use more loops. So these are the percussions, the kick and bass. And then comes one of my favorite things, the Atmosphere Maker. This is the playable one, so you can play whatever melodies you want with it. All you need to do is just move around all these knobs, but what I like to do is to look for a nice atmosphere using the random button. This one. I like that. Let's play with the kick and bass. Love that. Next up is the drones. Again, you can see loads of knobs. These are just different atmospheres you can play together. All you need to do is just push the random button. This is really great, especially when you make some drones, you know, in your breakdown to add a little bit more tension. Really cool one. And then we have a last one, which is filled with effects that you can just use in the background. Ooh. Oh yeah, this is cool. So all of these effects are supposed to help the track to feel a little bit more alive. Now, let's maybe add the pluck. Plucks have multiple different MIDIs that you can use. They are either separated into solo ones or also the chord ones. So let's start with the first one right away. I'm a big fan of chord one, so I'm gonna go with a chord one. And then we have a counter pluck. You can choose whichever you like. You can choose your own melody. It's actually all pretty simple. Now let's go to the effects section. Now effects are all modifiable. You choose your favorite crash, and then you can just transpose it and change the pitch. Which is pretty neat. And same thing you can do with a reverse crash. Downsweep. This is a pretty cool one because you can again modify it to your liking. So you create your own from scratch. Same with the upsweep, and then we have the FX clap, which is already pre-made. You can choose whichever clap you want, and it's gonna enhance any drops that you have there. Let's have a quick listen. How about we're gonna go for clap number 15? Ooh. This one's cool. Let's use that one. Same applies if you wanna play with the snare rolls. You actually have so many things to choose from, so you can change, let's say, the drive tone, the amount, or the tone itself. How snappy is going to be the tuning. How vintage is gonna be. You can just push the random button. I like this one. Maybe too much lows. There we go. Now the leads. For now, in every project you have a different set of leads and you can just change in between them by basically adding them from a different project. But all of them have a lead group FX which already like works on top of everything and it just makes them sound pretty cool. Let's just have a listen to this breakdown. If this happens, we still are playing from the session view, so all I need to do is hit this button and it's gonna stop playing. And I have a little surprise for you guys. I actually took some time and recorded JP8000 saw pads from my JP8000 and created a fresh new pad that you can actually use inside all of these projects. Listen. Well, isn't this fun? Like, there is so much more inside this Magicktron Music Maker. Of course, you can always change the sounds for your favorite sounds. Important thing is that you don't have to struggle creating the full track, and you don't have to struggle picking the right hi-hat. I hope it's gonna help many of you guys in order to make your tracks faster, more efficient, and with ease. Now, this one is on pre-order. It's coming out on the Christmas day with all of the projects for you to start cracking. With this tool, you can just do everything super fast and super easy. So I hope you guys will like it and enjoy using it.